not about race, as he says. What is it about? Here to debate, Earnest Byner, who played for the Browns, Redskins, and Ravens before going on to coach, and former NFL player Dante Stallworth, who, among other teams, played for the New England Patriots. Earnest Byner, I want to start with you. You say you're in favor of protest in general, but you don't think it should happen on game day, essentially on company time. Do your job. Explain.
Well, the thing about this, first of all, I like to say that we're getting caught up in some of the issues more than focusing on what is this really about. I do believe that we all have the freedom of choice, the freedom of speech, the freedom of protest. We all have that. But to me, the on your job is not the place where it needs to be done. Now, we do have platforms, and those platforms should be used outside of the game as opposed to at the stadium. And, you know, we talk about the veterans and, disrespecting the flag and disrespecting the country. We should respect the country. We do respect the country. And also, the fact is, we should be spreading more and more love as opposed to getting caught up in these issues about the flag, about the discrimination. You know, we gotta get some more love happening in our world.
Dante?
I think the number one issue when this initially started with Colin Kaepernick was to promote awareness, was to promote a conversation and inspire a conversation to bring this to the forefront. This is an issue that's been going on for a very long time. And until we're able to face these uncomfortable truths about our society and our criminal justice system in particular, I think that this conversation is going to be much, much more difficult. But I continue to go back to, and it's becoming redundant to for me to try to get people to understand, or at least to understand where they're coming from, how this has anything to do with the military, how this has anything to do with disrespecting or respecting the country, when players are human beings just like, you know, everyone else, and they are obviously allowed to and afforded their First Amendment rights. So when you say that someone can't or shouldn't do something at work, then you are limiting your number. The very First Amendment was the most important amendment that the founding fathers of this country thought that they should have as the number one amendment. So whenever you start to tell people this is when they can't talk or this is when they should talk, then anything is up for grabs, not only in the Constitution, but especially, again, with the most important of all, the First Amendment.
I want to play some sound from Tom Brady, obviously New England Patriots quarterback, someone who was friendly with Donald Trump, had a Made America hat in his locker last year. This is what he said just this morning on the radio about the president's comments. Let's listen.
I certainly disagree with, what he said and thought it was just divisive.
So, Earnest, to you, you say you would rather that these players not be protesting on the field. But what about the president's comments specifically when he called a player who would protest a son of a bitch? Is that appropriate for the president to say about people who play football professionally?
Well, I don't think any of the athletes are, look at themselves and characterize themselves as that. I think, when you try to balance what's going on, what has happened, in this country, and what has continued to happen, one of the things I think is paramount and thing that has happened here is this has galvanized a lot of people. This has brought a lot of people together. We need to use this energy in a way to produce the type of growth that is necessary. When I say that I feel like it's probably not a place where at your work to go ahead and protest. When I say that, I really mean that obviously you got freedom of expression. We do have that. And we do have the respect for the veterans. I mean, there's a lot of things that we're doing with different aspects of this life that is building. We need to build from this. We don't need to keep being divisive. We don't need keep focusing on the fact that we are divisive. We have a lot to build on. This country is a great country. We love this country, and we'll continue to try to to build from different aspects of the experiences that we go through.
You know, Dante, what do you say to people who say, you know, athletes, they should just go play the game, make this about sports, politics shouldn't be part of the game? Or what we've also heard from some supporters of the president, these players are all so privileged. They have the privilege to play this sport and make a lot of money. It's disrespectful not to stand during the anthem. How do you respond to those arguments, Dante?
There's a lot of people in this country who are making a lot of money, and for some reason, athletes or quote-unquote celebrities seem to draw the ire more than other people. You have executives on Wall Street who essentially ran this economy into the dirt, and no one talks about the money that they make, or no one talks about a game show host making tens of millions of dollars. So to me, that point is moot about how much money you make. I think when you're in a position to influence positive change, then you can't allow yourself to be deterred by what others are saying about you not being patriotic. I mean, again, this goes back to what Martin Luther King and Muhammad Ali told us and showed us about the Vietnam War. When it was not popular, people were calling them unpatriotic and anti-American. And we see that history has vindicated those men because they were against the Vietnam War when it was so obvious and clear-eyed for them, but not so for many others. And it's a similar situation with today in my eyes.
It's an important discussion. Dante Stallworth, Earnest Byner, an honor to speak with both you, fans of yours, for a long, long time. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
All right. To help-